إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد Alhamdulillah, all praise are due to Allah. All thanks are for Him. All good are in His good hands. No God deserves to be worshipped but He, Jalla wa Ala. We seek His forgiveness at all time, and to Him alone do we repent. May His peace and blessings be upon Muhammad al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his family members, his companions, and to all of those who follow their rightly guided path. Now, on the authority of Abu Huraira radiallahu anh, he narrates and he says the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ أَوَّلَ مَا يُحَاسَبُ بِهِ الْعَبْدُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ مِنْ عَمَلِهِ Salatu. That the first thing that the slave of Allah will be held accountable for from his deeds will be his salah. And if his salah is in order, then he has prospered and he has succeeded. And the day of reckoning will be easy for him. But if his salah is deficient, and it is lacking, then he has failed and he has lost. And the day of reckoning will be a difficult time for him. Now, the angel Jibra'il alayhi salam, he came down to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with numerous commandments, i.e., for us to fast during the month of Ramadan, to perform the Hajj, to avoid the major sins, to give zakah. But there is one commandment, one pillar, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He summoned the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to the heavens in the miraculous night journey. And in an hadith of Anas bin Malik radiallahu anhu, he says 50 prayers were obligated upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam during this miraculous night journey. It was reduced until it was set at 5. And then an announcement was made, Ya Muhammad, innahu la yubaddalu al-qawlu ladayy wa inna laka bihadhihi al-khams 50. O Muhammad, my word will never change. For these 5 prayers, they will be counted as 50. Now imagine we had to pray 50 times a day. That will be every 15 to 20 minutes, we'll be preparing for the next salah. Our whole life will be nothing but prayer. Allahu Akbar. Exemplifying the verse in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created humans and jinn for what? To worship Him alone. Now how kind and generous and merciful is our Rabb. But yet, with us only having to pray five prayers, and these five prayers will be counted as 50, just like in the hadith tells us, yet we fail to perform them properly. Like in the hadith of Ammar bin Yasir radiallahu anhu, he says, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, verily a man will leave from his salah and only a tenth will be written for him, or a ninth, or a eighth, or a seventh, or a sixth, or a fifth, or a quarter, or a third, or a half. And this is because some of us, when it comes to salah, we are not concentrating. We rush through our prayer. We let our gaze wander during the salah. Some of us, we constantly forget the amount of raka'at that we have performed. And our hearts, they're absent. But the action, it is present. Some of us during our salah, we are thinking what we are going to do after the prayer, when we leave the masjid. And some of us will have nothing written in terms of reward. Why? Because we nullify and we void our salah. How? When the imam is praying, some of us precede the imam before the imam says Allahu Akbar, to change from ruku' to standing, or from when the imam wants to go from standing to ruku', we precede the imam, and this nullifies and it voids the salah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not once in the Quran does he say sallu. He doesn't say just do the action of salah. He doesn't say just pray. What does he say? Establish the prayer. الَّذِينَ يُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةِ. Those of whom who establish the prayer. أقم الصلاة. Establish the prayer. And what does this mean? This means to perform it perfectly, at its time, fulfilling its conditions. Wudu or tayammum, facing the qibla, playing in a clean place, having khushu, understanding the words that you are reading. This is establishing the prayer. Now, on a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, narrated on the authority of Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, he says, a man, he came into the masjid while the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was sitting. And he came into the masjid and he performed two raka'at. After he had finished, he came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he gave him salam. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he replied to his salam. And he said to him, go back and pray, for you have not prayed. So the man, he went back and he prayed, just like he prayed the first time. And he came back to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he gave him salam again. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he replied to his salam. And he said to him, go back and pray, for you have not prayed. So the man, what did he do? He went back and prayed, just like he had prayed the first time. And he had finished and he came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he gave him salam again. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he replied to his salam. And he said to him, go back and pray, for you have not prayed. And what did the man reply? He said, by Allah, Ya Rasulullah, I do not know any better than this. Teach me, Ya Rasulullah. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to him, if you stand up for salah, say Allahu Akbar, takbiratul ihram. Then read what comes easy for you from the Quran. Then make ruku' until you are comfortable in ruku'. Then stand up until you are standing up straight. Then bow down and make sujood until you are comfortable in sajda. Then sit up in julus until you are comfortable while sitting. Then make sajda again until you are comfortable in this sajda. And do this for the entire salah. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he tells us in another hadith, he says, the worst thief among the people is a thief who steals from his salah. And the companions, they replied to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and they said, Ya Rasulullah, how can somebody be stealing from his salah? And he replied and he said sallallahu alayhi wasallam, that they are not completing their ruku and their sujood. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وبعد. In another hadith of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he was approached by a man and he asked him to teach him and make it concise. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he replied to him and he said to him, when you pray, pray as if you are praying your farewell salah. Pray as this is going to be your last salah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he tells us in the Quran, he says, inna as-salata tanha 'anil fahsha'i wal munkar. Indeed, salah, it prevents a person from evil doings and sins. And in a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he tells us, al-ahdu alladhi baynana wa baynahum as-salah. That the covenant, the contract between the believer and the disbeliever is what? What's the difference? It's the salah. فَمَنْ تَرَكَهَا فَقَدْ كَفَرْ. And whoever abandons salah, for indeed he has disbelieved. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he tells us in Surah Al-Ma'un, he says, فَوَيْلٌ لِلْمُصَلِّينَ. Woe to those people who pray. What type of people who pray? الَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنْ صَلَاتِهِمْ سَاهُونَ. Those who are heedless with their salah, and they do not pray at their fixed times. And in Surah Muddathir, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he tells us about the conversation between the people of paradise and the people of hellfire. And they say, مَا سَلَكَكُمْ فِي سَقَرْ. What is it that brought you to the hellfire? How comes you have entered the hellfire? And what do they reply the people of hell? They say, قَالُوا لَمْ نَكُ مِنَ الْمُصَلِّينَ. That we were not from the people who used to pray, who used to offer the salah. Now I want you to remember one thing, that your salah will be from the first actions that you will be held accountable for. And if your salah is found to be in order and not deficient, on the day of reckoning, you will be nothing but joyful. And if you have a deficiency in your salah, then this day will be a horrible day for you. Now, if you have enough time whilst you're at work to go to the bathroom, or you're at school to have a 5-minute break, then you have no excuse to say that you cannot pray. Salah doesn't take more than 6 to 7 minutes. Many of us will say, I'm working, so I'll pray when I come back home. La. This will be one thing that you will be held accountable for. One of the first things you will be held accountable for will be your salah. So do not compromise. Do not compromise your salah. Many places, many schools, many workplaces are accommodating now for you to have a 5-minute break. So you have no excuse not to pray your salah. اللهم يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك. اللهم يا مصرف القلوب صرف قلوبنا على طاعتك. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم تقبل صلاتنا. اللهم تقبل قيامنا. اللهم تقبل ركوعنا. اللهم تقبل سجودنا. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي. يا يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد وقوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم الله.